In this video, I want to derive the current voltage relationship for a PN diode, and I want to derive it for two cases. One is when there is no light shining on the diode, and that's called the dark IV relationship. And then I want to contrast it to the case where there is light shining on the diode, and that's in fact called very appropriately called the light JV characteristics. So let's start first with the case where we are in the dark, so there is no light shining on this PN diode. And then I can apply a voltage across this PN diode. So I can apply a voltage across this PN diode. And that voltage essentially results in a reduction of the built-in voltage across this diode. So let's say the built-in voltage, I'm applying a voltage of VA, and the built-in voltage was VBI. So now the potential difference between this PNN region, it reduces to VBI minus VA, and all of that applied voltage is essentially appears across this depletion region. So assuming that these PNN region have decent conductivity, so all that potential difference will occur across this depletion region where there's high resistance or no carrier presence. All this applied voltage occurs across this depletion region, and that results in splitting of these Fermi level into two of these quasi Fermi level, denoted by EFP, which is used to represent the carrier concentration of holes, and EFN, which is used to represent the carrier concentration of electrons. So now, I mean, thinking about it intuitively, what I'm doing is essentially there was this barrier for present for these preventing these diffusion of electrons from the n-type semiconductor into the p-type semiconductor. But now, since I've reduced this barrier, these electrons can essentially now go into the p-type semiconductor. Similarly, these holes which were present in the p-type semiconductor, they had now see a reduced barrier to come into the n-type semiconductor. So there's a flow of current which results as a consequence of that, and that can be represented essentially like a rectifier relationship, where this current density can be related to the applied voltage using this exponential formula, where it varies exponentially with the applied voltage, and it's also highly rectifying in nature, where just J naught, it essentially depends upon a lot of things. So it's given by this formula, which I'm stating over here. And it can be derived by applying the drift diffusion equation and the continuity equation across this diode. So this formula essentially says that my diode current at this J01, it's related to the diffusion constant in the PNN region, then it's related to the diffusion length, it's related to the doping density, and very importantly, it's related to the square of the intrinsic carrier concentration. So it's related to the square of the intrinsic carrier concentration. And if I chart this IV relationship, it would essentially look like an ideal rectifier relationship. So when I apply voltage in a positive direction, so if I forward bias this diode, there'll be exponential increase. There'll be an exponential increase in the current. And when I go into the reverse bias region, what I'll see is that my current it turns negative, and it does not essentially very much with the voltage. So in fact, if this VA becomes very negative, then my J will essentially, it will become equal to minus J01, and that's called the reverse saturation current. So this is how my IV relationship would look like. If I apply a positive voltage, there's a large change in my current, versus if I apply a negative voltage, there's a small change in my current. So now let's move to the case where we in fact apply light on this PN junction. So this This when I do apply light on this PN junction, and let's consider the case where the light the sunlight is shining from this direction, which is incoming from the P side. So this light will get, these photons will get absorbed inside these PNN regions, and they'll essentially result in the production, or they'll result in this creation of these electrons and hole pairs. And this can be represented by this generation rate, which would decrease as the light as the light traverses through this PN junction. As the light get absorbed, so the generation rate would decrease. So now the electron and hole pairs, which are generated inside this depletion region, and this is, I'm still considering the case where I'm applying this voltage of VA. So you saw that these electrons and holes earlier were flowing in this direction. But now when I'm shining light on this diode, these electrons and holes pair, which are generated in this depletion region, they would be essentially swept out. So this electron over here would get swept out into the end region, because these electrons like to travel down the hill. Similarly, these holes which are generated inside the depletion region, they would get swept out into the P region, and where they would be collected as a current. So it would result in this generation current, which is in fact opposite in polarity as compared to the other case. So I can say that my generation current due to this light shining on my diode, I can represent it by essentially integrating this generation rate over my depletion region. So I can integrate this generation rate, which is a function of distance, over this depletion region, and that would be essentially the current which is generated in the opposite direction due to the presence of this light. So let me write it down. So this generation current can now be written down by this formula, where it's integrated from the beginning of this depletion region. So let's say this is my zero coordinate. So it's integrated from minus xp to xn. And now I can write my overall current as a superimposition of the two currents flowing before, and the current which was flowing before any light was shining on this diode, and then superimpose this with this current which is now flowing due to the light shining. So my new IV relationship, or my new JV relationship for my diode, can essentially be represented by this formula, where it's a superimposition of what was happening before in the dark, and now it's superimposed with this other current which is flowing in the opposite direction. So now if I consider the case when I'm applying no voltage, or I'm applying zero voltage across my PN junction, I'm essentially shorting my PN junction, then the current that I would expect is, I can call this as the short circuit current. And if I put V applied equal to zero in this formula, so this term would vanish, and the current that I would get is essentially equal to this value. So I can represent this equation in terms of the short circuit current as J is equal to J01 exponential function of my applied voltage minus my short circuit current when I'm shining light. So now if I go back to this IV relationship that I had derived earlier, so I had mentioned that I can represent my diode IV relationship, and it looks very much like a rectifier. So if I write the JV relationship of a diode, let me write it first for the case where there is no light applied. And it looks something like this. So there is this is the case when there is a dark IV. Now if I apply a light, what I'm seeing essentially is that most of my JV relationship is the same, only that I have shifted it downward by this short circuit current. So now if I Consider the case where I have light applied on my junction. So my IV relationship would essentially look very much the same, but it would be shifted negatively in terms of the y-axis by this amount equal to the JSC. So it would essentially look something like this. And so if I look at this IV relationship, the region in which I can extract power out of this device would be when I'm operating this device in this fourth quadrant. So when I'm operating my device in this fourth quadrant, so I'm applying a positive voltage while I'm getting a reverse current. So this would be the case where I can use this PN junction as a solar cell.